I played safety bits, because, you know, if you're a lug nut and you LARP as a lug nut, you're a lug nut LARPer like me, you gotta have bits that are safe, so safety bits, because you can't just chew on bits that aren't safe, that are all rusty, and give you all sorts of tetanus and everything else. So they say, they probably invented that so they could use pokey sticks to make you frowny. You know, pokey metal pokey things. Cool. But yeah, that's on my mind, because that just kind of negates everything. And it's still kind of, that's why I spent so much time on the accompaniment. Subtitling it and transcribing it and everything else, because I just wanted to just read it over and over and just see if that's real, why it's real, and really everything else just kind of throws you out in a loop. I mean, what are you doing, Ralphie? What is this? Is it all a, it's all a joke to you, but there was about 8 dozen people that were kind of behind you. He kind of negated everybody, threw them all under a TV dinner stone.
There, it's really hot out. I don't know how to level with this. It's a mess. It's all a mess. So, just working on it. I was just thinking about, like Megalodon always said, he's a WIP. He's always improving. If he's always improving, how does he have time to do all that improvement with all that streaming live thing? But yeah, that's about it. I put some attachments on. I got all sorts of, coins and forms and stuff like that. So I'll just keep trying to do the best that I can, and also be a whip and always progress. But I'll try to stay away from the metaphysical convincing, because that ended up being a strange plot in the Megley fairy tale. Anyway, yeah, bye.
That's what happened last time. I'm not gonna bother putting it in an eye and all that stuff, because we have eyeballs already. We can see with our own two eyes. But yeah, I'm gonna just keep trying this. So room number 16. When was the last time you were 16? Did you believe in it? Was it your friend? Did you eat? You eat at 16? I've had 16 TV dinners. Hey, I'm gonna open up this freezer. Yeah, it's a thing on its own, probably be wondering all sorts of Q&As. Kind of wondered if I should talk to the grill. It's like, no, chill. So that is another update. I had an opportunity to adopt this grill, and it didn't. Yeah, I decided not to let it happen. I knew it was probably, it's a very, very big commitment to, bring a grill into your life. It's big, it's hard to transport, and, we actually talked, and there was actually some points of time where he said, hey, if you want, you want to take that, grill, this, and I was like, well, I could think about it. I might just put it in here, have a little bit of room. It's sort of like that spur of the moment where it's like, okay, you have this, and there's I'm not gonna say there's like years of lineage and history, but it's, you get the scent of it. Like it had that residue. Like it was seasons. It was in some ways beautiful. In some ways it was destined to be a no-go. It was something that you could hold on to, cherish, but you'd have to pass it down or let it go. And you could see the new model on the horizon, and it would remind you of home, or like a deck, or a really nice chair, and you could bring it up, and it'd be helpful for a lot of people. But when you're dreaming about chairs, it could really be anything. Could really be anything, and that could be, that could be you. You could be the one dreaming about that chair. So, or that gorilla, really any sort of item, device. I know it's probably not a great alternative, but of all the things in the world, I picked a portable chair, which I didn't even have with me, because I put it at the homestead to, shoot some stories about, and then, when you actually need it, I think right here would be pretty good. Just pull it out and just have it, Just have it. Be able to grab it. Maybe put some mixed flavors of seeds inside that little zipper, and put an alarm on that zipper, maybe like a little bell. Maybe even better, just put a bike bell inside the zipper, so when it opens, you can hear.
Hi, I'm Aaron Phillips for Expert Village. And there's nothing like a bike like this to make you start yelling out to random people on the street, "I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog too." Kind of makes you feel like the Wicked Witch of the West. All you need
is ducks. You care about that kind of stuff, don't you? Here, you eat that. Did you eat the food? What about you guys? Did you eat the food? I like to eat the food. Well, anyway. Take care, ducks. Take care, Ba. I don't know if you're into, if you know about the delay timers, microwave, but if you're not, you're in a retreat. So check this out. You can do a cook 1500. You can do power level 5. Or PL5. Two times a day, so you press start. I'll give you this delayed start. I'll show you. This is DS for delayed start. And that makes you so happy. I know it makes me happy, so that's why I'm gonna put you right here. And then we'll go talk a little bit while this, we'll wait for the delayed start to happen. So anyway, I'm going to let the decor. It's by a famous artist named BH, 3H. I don't know who he is, but he's got a good composition. I dig it. I don't know if you dig it, but if you dig it, very good shovel. This is going to get up. Here it comes. Just like that. I'm not even next to it. It's just starting. It's not starting on its own free will, but you could say
You think about all the opportunities you could do to make that useful? Could you? I could just think like, man, you know, maybe later on, something's, you know, you're cruising, and your beach cruiser here, get your little thing, and shout outs to Expert Village, Aaron Phillips, hope he's doing alright. Probably reach out for comment, because he's pretty deep. So, anyway, I gotta go. Take care, bye. I'm sure which Pbnj this is. I'm not even really sure how to coordinate this thing, Bobber, and I'm gonna just you. That's half decent. Get a little bit of the mess over there in the corner. So, today's discussion's about, I don't even know. I mean, really, I don't know what's kind of going on in this world. I just kind of, I see it as it comes and goes, and I have to pick out which fish to fry, which TV dinners to cook at 50. It's thingamabobber 5, or, you know, just whatever things that are going on in this thing, and I just kind of go with it. Go with the flow. Okay. Towel over there. And, man, I don't know. I mean, I just don't know. And lastly, you're thinking, what do I have left? Yeah, this remote. It's got no bright star remotes. BR-1100Z. BR-100Z. And it's, hang on a second. I was able to cut that one out of time. But it's sort of like, it's a remote. It's, I don't know how universal it is. It's, it doesn't have the universal things. Thinking I might invest in another universal one, because the one I had was all sort of, had a discoloration over the years, and I could probably use another one, because even though this one says setup, and in life everything's a setup, it doesn't set up anything. It doesn't even set the light on. So I'm thinking, you know, over time, this device, it's decided that it wants you to be able to change volumes and everything else. As far as any of these little buttons, only previous channel works. The other ones just doesn't have a heart. Hope to move anymore, to bring you to the next chapter. So you can, I'm thinking maybe with the universal, even if it doesn't work, I can set it up to coincide with other devices that I normally wouldn't deal with. But we're dealing with like an optical LAN with Hadoumis. And ether reel cables and unready lives and executions of those lives, and we're just trying to get to the next step. And just like you, I don't know if you're gonna get the next step. I don't know if I'm either. I don't know. Can't answer that for you. You're gonna have to do your best regardless. So take care. Bah. I bet you're wondering, like, what is going on here? You're thinking, like, what is all that, you know? That's just my usual sort of everyday clutter. It even has, you bring out a little table and stuff. Chair for you guys to sit on. It's just for you guys. You enjoy it, and May's roommate is still inside of the frame. I like the frame. I like to. It's got a nice finish to it. Wasn't pricey. Wasn't anything like that. But holds a little TV dinner in my TV dinner. I got this little picture too. So anyway, there is that, and there can be that. It's like the coolest forklift like I have seen. It has seen heck and back. Oh man. Anyway, I'm Gel. Pbnj to the chat. Hello again. Okay. Hello in pine cones. Respect to hexagons. Sup everybody. Hello pilgrim. Welcome to whatever this is. Pbnj to the chat. Hopefully everybody's. This is the part where I say hopefully everybody's getting situated with the situated. I don't know. I mean, it's been an interesting sort of set of events. It's troublesome getting all this, waking up and living in this world where you do stuff in the AM and, you know, end up at the PM, the early PM, where it's all a big mess. About to head into this office over here, but I'm just gonna show off this. Found a secret grill. It's a secret grill. It's like a secret garden, but it's a grill. It's a secret grill. And then also what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take one of those crates that I got, I'm thinking about it. Put a blanket in it. Carry it in. We can get some goodies. See if we can pick out some cool stuff. I'm gonna need it. Bring the blanket in for the chat. Well, not for the chat, for me. Anyway, I'll show you the secret grill over here. So, okay, we're walking steps here. Here's the secret grill, man. So it's real nice. It's a char griller. I don't know what's wrong with it. It's probably cursed by a ghost, but it's even got all the tools and everything in it too. A little bit dirty. Maybe this is just where they just have their afternoon picnics or something, but it's pretty cool. I like the fact that there's a secret grill. It's like a secret garden, but for grills. I'm wondering if they just had to let it go or something, but it's just so old school. It's got wheels and just, it's a darling little grill. Whenever I see it, I just feel like I see hope, you know? Let's see. Like just gives you probes even, so I don't even want to go into, but yeah, just real nice. It blends in with the world. So anyway, yeah, I think I'm crazy sitting here taking, you know, circling around the grill. It's just like that time that I had to stop and look at a cool forklift. So that was a cool forklift. Anyway. They hold no whatnots, so they don't hold any whatnots. So I'm gonna just say it's probably the safety of everyone's peril. It's a risk. It's a risk, and a bisque that you stir a lot and make sure that it's got a nice. And then you put it in a little container that you can quaff at any time. Potion of fulfillment. So it brings you over, brings you in there, gives you those things. Those things would be, it wouldn't be those things without you, or probably just you. I'd say me as well, but not. Don't wanna bring that up. So you just kind of do really the best you can to get your things figured out. And then you kind of hope for the best. So anyway, that's what I got. One thing I wanted to show you guys.
Alright, there she is. Real quick.
What I've been doing is once in a while, like, you get a lot of groceries, don't matter what it is. You kind of, this little fitness tip, just put it on one of these big old hooks.